Come on, open up your mouth. Let that praise fill the atmosphere. And let the glory come into your life. Let that praise fill the atmosphere. Let the power of God come into your life. Come on, Zion, open up loud, proud, with a mighty voice. Hallelujah! 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 Oh, glory. Oh, glory. While you're standing, touch and agree with somebody, I don't care if you're half of them.
I've been going in circles from the time you was a little boy up until the point where you are right now. And so it's time out for talking about change, and it's time for us to realize the change that only God can bring into our lives. And so we got to understand that when God does something, he does not do it by the mandate of men. He don't have to follow the rules of people, for he is God all by himself. And I need to find somebody in this house today that needs real change in your life, that does not follow the rules of men. You need God to break some rules in your life.
It's going to be all right. I'm going to work with this thing. Praise him. Amen. So God has the power to bring real change in our lives that supersedes the limitations of men. God breaks the rules of nature. Amen. In the book of Joshua, amen, the army of Israel needed, amen, a little more time. Praise God. Is there anybody in here that needs a little more time before you can get victory in your life? Amen. Some of you feel the rules of time causing you to make hasty decisions because somebody told you that you're running out of time. You started accepting anything and everything into your life because somebody told you that you're running out of time. You stopped believing that God is able to take control of time. And so in the book of Joshua, the army of Israel were running out of time. But Joshua had enough faith in God to say, God, I need you to put a pause in the day because I'm so close to my victory. But the rules of time say that the sun has got to go down and the moon has got to rise. But then Joshua had the mindset to say, God, I need you to hold up time so I can get my victory. And there's some of you that the days are lapsing and you're starting to feel like you got to make a hasty decision. Because of the rules of time, it makes you think that God is no longer able to bring you out of your current situation. But I rose to tell you that God is about ready to break the rules of time. Somebody holler, Lord, give me a little more time. I'm going to need some time with this. Nature declared that the sun should go down and the praise God, the moon should rise, but God decided to break the rule of nature and to bring about victory. Somebody holler, I need victory in my life. Praise the Lord. God has the ability to break the rules of nature. Not only that, my brothers and my sisters, I am reminded of Abraham and Sarah. Now Abraham and Sarah was getting up there in age, and some would say that after you get a certain point that you cannot have any more children. And so it is that Abraham and Sarah, amen, they stepped out of the will of God and they brought in a third party named Hagar. And praise God, Abraham got Hagar pregnant and she brought forth a son named Ishmael. And you know that was not the promise of God.
Sometimes when we want something so bad, we'll push God on the side. And we say, God, you haven't shown up. Hey, praise God, you haven't done what I asked you to do. So I'm going to do it myself. But praise God, God still had Abraham and Sarah in mind. And although they messed up, I need you to be honest and transparent. And if you've ever messed up, lift up your hands and say grace. Because it's nothing but the grace of God that kept you, although you messed up. But despite the mistake that Abraham and Sarah made, God still had control of time. And at the appointed time, God began to deal with Abram. And he said, Abram, you're going to have pleasure with your wife again. And you're going to bring forth a son. But praise God, Sarah heard. She heard it in the background. And she began to laugh. Some of you going to laugh when you hear about the miracle that God is going to bring into your life. Some of you going to laugh because you thought that it was over. But high five your neighbor and say, neighbor, it ain't over until God says it's over. Oh, praise the Lord. Can I preach? Should I preach? I believe I preach in this house. And so it is that Abraham, praise God, he stepped into Sarah's chamber. Now you know it's been a long time before they was able to get busy. But praise God, it happened a night that Sarah, she was feeling pretty good. Abraham, with his old self, stepped in the room, and Sarah said, boy, what you doing in here? And Abram, he said, listen, I'm here for business. God, God, he broke some rules. So when it looked like we couldn't, we wouldn't get together again, God, he rekindled my fire. Is anybody in the house today whose fire has gone out and you need the Lord to light your fire? Say, Lord, light my fire. Lord, start it up again. Lord, fix it for me.
Y'all sit down. I shut it up. Hallelujah. And so we know that God has the ability to break the rules of nature when it looked like it could never happen. When it looked like it would not happen. God, he spoke it into existence. Somebody say, Lord, speak it. Break the rules. I feel that right there. Somebody was told that you didn't qualify for a job, and you know you don't qualify. But say, Lord, break the rules. I know that I don't qualify. I know it requires a degree. I know it requires X, Y, and Z. But Lord, break the rules. Lord, break the rules.
Y'all gonna really make me preach, huh? Ah, Lord have mercy. Men and women, boys and girls, all throughout the scripture, we read about people that were born with certain conditions. There are some that will say that if you born that way, you stayed that way. There were men and women that were born blind. There were others that were born deaf. And yes, there were for those that were born lame. But somehow or another, they received the miracle. I need to hear you holler that word. Somebody say miracle. I feel that in my spirit. You thought that the days of miracles ended with the Bible. But I rose to tell the church that God, oh sister Destiny, he still works miracles. I found somebody around you and say God still works miracles. God still does the incredible. God still does the phenomenal. God is a miracle working God. Stand up on your feet and come on in this house and let's give God praise. Let's give him glory. If you want a miracle, if you believe God is a miracle working God, throw up those hands and tell the Lord, thank you for being my personal miracle worker. Thank you for making a way for me. Thank you for opening doors in my life. Hallelujah. Oh, oh, I need to hear you praise him. Hallelujah. I don't care. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I don't care what you was born into. It don't matter with God. You may have been blind. You may have been deaf. You may have been broke or broken. But I stop by to tell you that God, he controls nature. Say yes. Say yes. Y'all sit down, sit down. Oh, praise him. Oh, hallelujah. He has the ability to break the rules of time. I sense today an out of cycle blessing. I sense today that something good is coming into your life. Somebody holler yes. Say yes. Say yes. Hallelujah. God is about to give you a premature blessing. It ain't even developed yet. It ain't even 9 months. But your baby is about to arrive. I see it in the spirit. God is about to bring it early. What you thought you would have to wait for, what you thought would take years, God will reduce it to weeks. Oh God, hallelujah. Oh, praise him. Good. Hallelujah. Somebody say, God, break some rules for me. Hallelujah. God, step in the line for me. God, do a ridiculous blessing in my life. Men and women, they were born blind. Some were born deaf. Others were born lame. But they received a miracle from God. God broke the rules of medical science. If, praise God, you can only believe, it won't stay this way. I need somebody in here to declare and decree. I need a believing church to open up your mouth and declare and decree. It won't always be this way. It won't always feel this way. Hallelujah. Ask your neighbor and say, neighbor, it's about to get better for you. Weeping may endure for a night. I feel that. But joy is going to come in the morning. Jump up off of your seat if you can believe. Believe it and give God a praise in advance. Give God glory. Give God honor. Say it. Ooh. Well, praise him. Don't be afraid to ask God to cross the line for you. Don't be afraid to ask God to break some rules. Don't be afraid to ask God to defy the odds. Don't be afraid to ask God to open the door. Don't be afraid to ask God to heal your body. Don't be afraid to ask God to touch your mind. Don't be afraid to ask God to do what you can only do in my life. Ask God.
What's that of the most? Hey, glory. Sarah had Isaac. I said, Sarah had Isaac. It simply shows us that God's timing is not our timing. Testify to your neighbor, say, he may not come when you want him, but he'll be there right on time. Somebody give God an on-time praise. Will look like it would. It happened anyway. He fixed it anyway. He heals you anyway. He did it anyway. Clap your hands. Open up your mouth. Pray. If God did it anyway, shout glory.